Come on, students. In the second, in the eighth session, I am going to talk about the reactions of pyrrole. So, we have written the resonance structures of pyrrole, where the electrons are involved in the resonance and we get the different resonance structures. So, it is more reactive due to charge separation in the resonance structures. It gives reactions due to acidic nature. And it reaction gives to the basic nature and it gives electrophilic substitution. These are the three reactions we have to discuss. First, let us say, due to presence of lone pair of electrons on nitrogen, it behaves like a case. But this lone pair of electrons is not readily available for the donation, since it is involved in delocalization. Donation of lone pair of electrons is difficult, so therefore it is a weak case. As per Lewis concept, any compound which donates a pair of electrons is a base. Easier the donation of electrons, stronger the base, and difficult the donation of electrons. Since the electron donation is difficult, it is involved in delocalization, so it is a weak base. So when it is treated with mineral acids like HCl, as I told, we cannot use strong concentrated acid for pyrrole because it will undergo significantly polymerization. Hence, we cannot use strong acid. So on treating dilute HCl, it gives a soft base reaction acid to form the salt. This is pyrrochloride. It's a stable salt. So it shows that it is basic in nature. All compounds contain a lone pair of electrons. They are basic in nature. So it reacts with hydrochloride to form salt, pyrrohydrochloride. Therefore, it is a base. Now, when you see the nature of hydrogen and hydrogen bonding, nitrogen is more electronegative than hydrogen. This electron pair present between nitrogen and hydrogen is pulled towards hydrogen and partial positive charge is added by hydrogen. So, it can be removed as a plus by a base. If you add a strong base, then it can remove the H+ and converts it into salt. So, if you treat it potassium hydroxide, which is a strong base, then H+, OH-, OH- subtracts H+, and K+, H+ is replaced by K+ to form the salt. Plus, salt and water, potassium pyrrole. The way H+ is replaced by metal ion, so it is a salt. So any compound where H+ can be replaced by metal ion is acidic. Due to difference in electronegativity, hydrogen can be replaced by H+. So it is a weak acid. PKA is 15, very very weak acid. So this H+ is abstracted by a base like potassium hydroxide, or it reacts with a glycol reagent. I take orange S, glycol reagent. Where it is delta minus carbon magnesium bond is polar, carbon is more electronegative than magnesium, therefore delta minus delta minus. So here you can take any compound like CH3, MgI. alkyl magnesium chloride. This is ethyl magnesium. Ethyl magnesium. Anyone you can use. So if you take any alkyl chloride, this carbon ion goes to this one. It takes H plus and converts into or corresponding hydrocarbon. This hydrogen goes to this R minus carbon ion. So it's CH3 minus plus H, it becomes CH4 here. In this case, it becomes CH4. So then it is. So the salt again. So where the negative charge is present. So hydrogen ion is removed by. So these two reactions show that it is a weak acid. Now let us see the electrophilic substitution reaction are free. As you know, all electrophilic compounds undergo electrophilic substitution reaction, like saturated compounds, which is the characteristic reaction of saturated compounds. So electrophilic substitution reaction example, there are nitration, sulfonation, halogenation, Friedel-Crafts alkylation, Friedel-Crafts acylation. Then, Kolbe's Smith reaction. And Riemann-Lehmann reaction. These are the different reactions, which are known as electrophilic substitution reactions. Nitration, sulfonation, halogenation, Friedel-Crafts alkylation, acylation, Kolbe's reaction, Riemann-Lehmann reaction. So pyrrole, let us take reactions of these reactions of pyrrole. I told you can't use concentrated acid because under acidic condition it undergoes polymerization. So we have to use the mild condition. For this, we have to use cold nitric acid. Dilute cold nitric acid in presence of acetic anhydride. Nitrate solution is generally mixture of nitric acid and sulfuric acid. But here you can't use sulfuric acid because sulfuric acid is strong acid. So therefore instead of sulfuric acid, acetic anhydride is used. So when it is heated with nitric acid, cold dilute nitric acid in presence of acetic anhydride, then electrophilic substitution, the equation tells us NO2 plus is the electrophile in this reaction. Then what attack the second position? So we get two nitro-pyro. Electrophilic substitution in the reaction takes place at second position. Two nitro. Then for sulfonation, generally sulfonation takes place by heating concentrated sulfuric acid, where sulfur dioxide is the electrophile. Sulfur dioxide is generated from sulfuric acid, but here we can't use sulfuric acid and we directly use sulfur dioxide. Sulfur dioxide itself is used in place of sulfuric acid in place of UV. UV is the same as at about 100 degrees centigrade. You deal with the sulfur dioxide, you can substitute sulfonation takes place. So we get pyrrole 2 sulfonates. Pyrrole 2 sulfonates. Nitration, electrophilic electrophiles. In case of sulfonation, sulfur dioxide is neutral electrophile. So, instead of sulfuric acid, we sulfur trioxide directly, or we heat it with sulfur trioxide, sulfonation reaction, we get that pyrrole to the sulfonic acid. Then for high alkylation, we cannot use chlorine because it is an oxidizing agent, so therefore we use SO2 sulfuryl chloride, pyrrole. Sulfuryl chloride is ether. Ether is the salt at 0 degrees. Then chlorination takes place. So for halogenation, so it won't attack all the positions. Whereas here only mono substitution takes place here. The reaction stops at first. But here, once the halogen is attached to one position, other positions also become active, and all the four positions are substituted. So we get Cl. All the four positions are occupied by angle. So it is 2, 3, 4, 5, tetra chloro. Tetra chloro. And if you use iodine, it plays a potassium, it's potassium. Pyrrole reaction iodine and potassium hydride. Iodination takes place. Halogenation, chlorination. If you use bromine, it plays a chlorine, bromination. Here it is iodination. So we get I. So it reacts with aqueous potassium, then we get tetraiodine. So halogenation, but it does not undergo critical cross reaction. Pyrrole do not undergo Friedel Crafts reaction because we are using alkane halide in presence of aluminium chloride and hydroxyaluminium chloride, which is a very white acid. So the reaction do not take place under this condition. So pyrrole do not undergo Friedel Crafts reaction. Then for coal based reaction, which is to be studied in case of phenol converts into salicylic acid, converts into, we get phenol converts into salicylic acid in coal based reaction. So here pyrrole, when it is still potassium carbonate, when it is heated to 100 degrees centigrade, then carboxylic group is substituted. Carboxylic acid. The group is such that it is pyrrole 2 carboxylic acid, carboic acid. Whatever you want to be right. Pyrrole 2 boic acid or pyrrole 2 carboxylic acid. Then Riemann-Riemann reaction, then it is treated with the chloroflora and potassium hydroxide. While pyrrole is treated with the chloroflora and potassium hydroxide, all the heavy group is substituted. Second question. Pyrrole to all the heavy. So this is the common. These are the electrophilic substitution reactions of pyrrole. Only under minor conditions, pyrrole undergoes electrophilic substitution reaction. Thank you very much. So in the last 6 seconds, I am going to talk about reactions of